I'm Molly Joyce, and I'm a composer and performer whose work is largely concerned with disability as a creative source. So at this age of 7, my family and I were involved in a car accident on a road trip. My recovery involved a lot of surgeries, especially immediately after the accident, and kind of exploring other ways to kind of regain physicality and sensation in my hand. Of course, broke my arm with the accident and then lost 2 out of the 3 nerves in my kind of hand-arm area. With each surgery and with each day of middle school and high school, I was veering far more away from kind of the so-called normative. I was afraid of gym class. I always wanted to wear long sleeves all the time, hide all my scars. To be honest, I almost wanted my hand like amputated in a way. I just wanted to get rid of it. I felt like it was just this reminder of something I'll never get back to be honest. Like when I look back at, there's not, I guess, a lot of pictures, but pictures with me with, say, 2 called normal hands. You know, it's just an interesting feeling in a way that you'll never have that back.
Side by side, which is tight. Left and right.
Largely due to my mother's encouragement and, of course, the elementary school orchestra teacher and my physical therapist. I had these kind of early experiences with cello, and I also adapted to trumpet, but really trying to conform to these instruments that really weren't made for my body at all. They're very, I think, made for a very specific set of abilities, I like to say. That's why I was so attracted to music composition in a way, and that I didn't have to think about my hands or what they could or could not do at all. I could kind of let my imagination, let my brain run free. So I found my vintage toy organ on eBay when I was, I believe, a freshman going on a sophomore, and it sat in my dorm room for a while because I kind of, almost like my disability in a way, I thought it was kind of too small or too limited in its own right. So when I started performing on it more, I felt like it was almost too good to be true, like it was made for my body. I didn't have to try to make my hands do one thing or the other they didn't want to do or weren't supposed to do in a way, and just kind of set off this lifelong journey of exploring disability as a creative source. It really opened up a whole new world for me, and I don't think I'll ever go back. Disability is really an identity and experience for us all to engage with. I don't necessarily want it to look like I overcame my disability or it's something to be inspirational to others, but it's really something to be engaged with in its own lane. I think it speaks to the power of, again, disability in itself and the power of art, that it kind of tells you things you don't even know about yourself in a way before you fully realize them.